If you think that COVID has Australians bunkering down, here's the proof that they're not. According to the Bureau of Statistics, thousands of people have deserted our capital cities in search of a safer life.
And the research shows there's one city in particular that residents are fleeing. For more, we're joined by demographer Mark McCrindle. Mark, good morning to you. Morning. Always great to have you on. So before you tell us where everyone's going, tell us why they're leaving.
Well, our cities have long had a problem with affordability, as we know, the cost of housing, and some of our cities have had a problem with livability as well because they're getting bigger, congestion, commute times. They have had the benefit of employability, though, because most of the jobs in Australia have been in our capitals. That's now changed. Post-COVID, people can work from home, they can work from the regions, and so now regional cities have the benefit of affordability and livability and employability as well, and so Aussies in the capitals are making the move.
I personally know of five families after COVID who have all now left a big city. Which city has the most migration?
Well, if we look at the data, Sydney has lost the most, and this is the last 3 months of last year. The numbers would have been bigger, but we were still in lockdown. Melbourne was still in lockdown. We still had quarantine across state borders. So Melbourne's numbers will get worse in the months ahead, but they lost a lot. And as we could expect, Brisbane and Perth picked up a lot of numbers. They were COVID-free, but also the house prices, and there's been a trend anyway towards moving to the north, to Queensland, and across to the west.
So we saw that nobody actually moved to Melbourne in these figures at all, which makes sense because they were in the middle of lockdown.
They couldn't get in there, could
yes.
they?
Did many people move to Sydney, though?
Not many, and keep in mind that these were the lowest numbers of interstate movement that we've seen for the best part of 6 years. So they'll get bigger now that state borders are opened again.
Mm. What about this 11,000 unaccounted people?
Well, we saw on the capital cities some grew and some went backwards, but if we look overall at our capitals, they went down by 11,000 people. So these are the people not moving from one capital to another, but moving from a capital city to a regional area within their state. This was the largest movement we've ever had on record. People within a state moving from a capital to a region, and that's the big trend. People moving from Sydney to Moree or the Bathurst or other regional areas like Wagga.
The other part of this research that I just thought was fascinating was that people aren't just relocating, they're also making other big life decisions.
Well, exactly. You know, if you think about moving home, you're also going to think about moving job. A lot of people have been able to pick up jobs that otherwise they couldn't because they can work remotely now. And with that, and with working from home, people have reassessed their home and recognised that that's not quite right for them. Maybe you need that spare bedroom if you're going to do a lot of work from home. And all of that has led to other changes in our life as well.
Yeah, interesting stuff. Mark McCrindle, always great to talk to you. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Mark.